So in the morning, we saw what are the different steps in hypothesis testing, what is hypothesis, what is alternate hypothesis, what is null hypothesis, what is population sample, degree of freedom, all these things we checked, saw in the morning today, right? Now we are going to see what are the different types of tests that are performed in hypothesis testing, right? So in our syllabus, there are two main tests. Those are T test and F test. Out of this T test is used to check the means of any two samples. See what is happening. Imagine that there is some kind of a population, complete population, say India's population, right? And we want to check, we want to do a simple survey. What is the simple survey that we want to do? Simple survey is, will India win the 2020 World Cup? Okay, win the T20 World Cup, right? This is a simple question. Now, currently, what is the average age of India? Currently, the average age of India's population is somewhere between 20 to 30. Let us say, for sake of current argument, that it is 25. Okay, and now you cannot test the, this is entire India's population, right? This is entire India's population. Now, when you are doing the survey, will India win the T20 World Cup? You are not going to go and ask everyone in India. You will ask only specific people in India, right? So imagine that you ask the question, you are taking the sample, this is the entire population, and you are taking a small sample of this population. But in your case, the average age of the population is, say, let us 50. Okay? There is some sampling error on your side, and you have taken a sample whose average age is 50. Now just imagine what will be the difference in result. There will be big difference in result, because what an average 25-year-old thinks about the Indian cricket team is different from what a 50-year-old person thinks about the Indian cricket team, right? So see, just because the average age of these two samples is different, we might get two different results. This is the same thing which happens in other factors also. For example, if you are doing some kind of manufacturing process, and you are manufacturing a large number of parts, okay? But if you take a sample from that, which is only from one batch, imagine that you are producing all these things in batches. Okay, batches of 10, right? You are producing a lot of products, but they are being produced in batches of 10. And you take all the 10 samples from just a single batch for testing, right? And based on this, you cannot tell about the information of all the batches, right? So what ideally you should do, you should take 1 1 1 1 from each, na? So this is proper sampling. What you are doing over here is not proper sampling. Okay, so that is why we require a t-test. What is the use of t-test? T-test checks if the mean average of the sample is equal to the average of the population. What is one function of t-test? One function of t-test is used to ensure that the average or mean of the sample is given by x bar. It is equal to the mean of the population. Okay, this is one function of the t-test. What is other function of t-test? Other function of t-test can be like, imagine that you are testing the effect of, let us say, a certain drug. Okay, effect of a certain drug, this is the tablet, on humans, right? Now, this drug is powerful. Let us say it has power of 100 mg. Okay. Now, this same drug is taken by males also, and this same drug is taken by females also. Right? What is happening? On an average, male have a higher body mass, right? As compared to females have a less body mass, right? So this 100 mg will have a different effect on males and different effect on females, right? So because this is different, we should treat this as different, right? But if we say that this is having the same effect on males and females, then that is not correct. So whenever we are analyzing the output of male samples and we are analyzing the output of female samples, we have to check if the values of male samples and female samples are also equal or not. Is the average of male and female equal or not? If it is equal, then we can think that they are coming from the same population. If they are coming different, then it means that these two samples are completely different, right? So this is another way in which the t-test is used. The t-test is used to compare the means of two different samples, right? So we will look at all this, but this is generally where t-test is used. So t-test was first used in So t-test was first used by this person called William Gossett. He used to work in this Guinness brewery in Dublin. And what was he trying to see? He was trying to see the chemical properties of barley. Okay. A brewery is where they make beer. So it is made from barley. So he was seeing whether the chemical properties of barley have any effect on the quality of beer that is produced. Okay. So that is what he was trying to see. And for that, he wanted to do the t-test. So that is where this comes from, right? So see, this is what I mean to say. What is exactly happening in t-test? See, I will just give you just one example. First, we will see this sample. And from this, I will just, because we have seen this some before, right? This modified, unmodified thing we have seen before only. We have seen ki the person wanted to reduce the curing time of cement, so he added some kind of additive to the cement because of which the curing time was reduced, but at the same time the bond strength was also reduced. Now based on this, we are seeing that the average bond strength of unmodified mortar is greater than the average bond strength of modified mortar. Okay. This is something which we have seen in the previous lecture. But we want to ensure that this difference is not just because of sampling error. Just because of sampling error, this is not coming. This is coming correctly because if it is because only of sampling error, then it is of no use, right? If it is coming out, if there is no sampling error, then we can definitely say that the modified mortar has less strength as compared to the unmodified mortar. Okay, so that is what we are going to do in our t-test. Okay, so now we will see how this t-test works. So basically, see over here, this is a very good explanation of t-test, this diagram. See, if this is my sample 1 and this is my sample 2, and this is how the probability is distributed. Okay, this is case 1, this is case 2, and this is case 3. In all three cases, you will see that the difference in means is same. This is the mean 1, this is the mean of sample 1, and this is the mean of sample 2. The difference in the means, mu 2 minus mu 1, is same in all three cases. Case 1 also, case 2 also, and case 3 also. But what can you say? See, in this case, I can clearly say that there is some sort of difference between these two, right? There is some sort of difference between these two. If someone gave me this sample and this sample, I would clearly be able to distinguish between green sample and blue sample, right? On the other hand, if someone is comparing in this case, if someone gives me a sample from here, can I for guarantee tell that it is from the blue or it is from the green? No, I am not easily able to distinguish between blue and green. Why? Because the amount of variance is very high, right? And what is the case in this? In this case, we cannot be 100% sure whether the variance is there or whether the variance is not. Here we will actually have to use the t-test. Here we can definitely say that the means are different. Here we can definitely say that the means cannot be said to be different. And here we cannot say anything. Here we will have to perform the t-test to check whether the means are same or the means are different. Right? So this is what is t-test. In t-test, what do we do? In t-test, we compare the difference in the means. We compare the difference in the means to the variance. Okay, to the variance. So what is the formula for t-test? If you see over here, just a minute. If you see the formula for t-test, the formula for t-test is a ratio. What is the ratio? Ratio is difference between the group means, which means this, mean 1 minus mean 2, right, divided by variability of the groups. Variability of the groups means what? Variability of the groups means its standard deviations. Okay, rather its variance. Okay, sorry. What is the variance of these groups? Okay, so that is what we are doing. Imagine if the mu 2 minus mu 1 is very high, this distance is very high and this distance is very low. Okay, mu 2 mu 1 is very high and this distance variance is very low. Then in that case, what will happen? The t value, this is known as the t value. See here also they are given. The t value will be very high, right? If t value is very high, then we can clearly say that the means of the two samples are different. Means of the two samples are different. But if the t value is very low, what does it mean? It means that mu 2 minus mu 1 is less and the variance is very high. So we cannot easily distinguish between the means of the two samples. So if t value is high, t value high means that the means of the two samples are different. And if the t value is low, it means that the means of the two samples are same or similar. Okay, not same, but approximately similar. Okay, that is what the t-test tells us. T-test is used to compare the means of two samples. Okay, so these are just the assumptions for t-test. This is just a theory part. You can just read it. And t-test assumes that the variance should be same for both of them. Okay, variances among groups should be equal. The number of samples should be less than 30. For higher number of samples, go for z-test. That the data should be a bell-shaped curve, normal distribution. Observation should be randomly selected, as I said. And it should be continuous. Okay, it should not be discrete data, it should be a continuous data. Right, so these are the assumptions of your t-test. Right, so what are the different types of t-test? There are three types of t-test. One sample t-test. In one sample t-test, what do we do? In one sample t-test, we are given the mean of the population. We are given the mean of the population and we are given some samples. We have to calculate the means of these samples and we have to check whether there is any significant difference between the two means. Okay, what do we do in one sample t-test? In one sample t-test, they give us the population's mean, which is mu. They give us samples. From that sample, we can find out the sample mean and we check if there is any significant difference between the sample mean and the population mean. Okay, in two sample t-test, what do they do? They give us two samples. We have to find the mean of the first sample. We have to find out the mean of the second sample. And we have to check if there is any significant difference between the two means. If there is a significant difference between the two means, it means that some change has taken place. If there is no significant difference between the two means, it means that both these samples can be assumed to be similar. Okay. And what is the third? Third is paired two sample t-test. Okay, we will, when I do the sums, I will explain it in detail. But in paired two sample t-test also, we have two samples. But in this case, the samples are somehow related to each other. Okay, there is 1-1, 2-2, 3-3. Okay, they are related to each other. And we find the mean of this. And we find the mean of this. And we see if there is significant difference between the two means. Okay. So when we solve the sums, we will see all of them.